बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज द विटामिंस बाय डॉक्टर केंथ वॉकर। डॉक्टर केंथ वॉकर वॉज अ कंसल्टेंट सर्जन इन लंडन। ही वॉज अ प्रोलिफिक राइटर। द विटामिंस इज एन एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम हिज बुक ह्यूमन फिजियोलॉजी। हिज स्टाइल इज नीट, सिंपल एंड स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड। इट सूट्स हिज पर्पज एक्सलेंटली। In this essay, the vitamins, the writer says that proteins, fats, carbohydrates, salts, and water are some important ingredients of our food. They help man's body work properly and repair its wear and tear. But health cannot be maintained simply on a diet based on these substances. There are certain essential ingredients in the food whose absence causes various diseases. These essential ingredients are chemical bodies called vitamins. Vitamins, like the enzymes and the internal secretions of different glands, have great effect on the body. There are two kinds of vitamins, fat-soluble and water-soluble vitamins. The letters of the alphabet are used to distinguish them. Okay, I will discuss the main points of this essay. Number one is, we cannot maintain our health on a vitaminless diet. Number two is, the absence of vitamins causes many diseases like scurvy, beriberi, paralysis, dropsy, stunted growth, deficiency of resistance, and non-calcification of bones, rickets, sterility, infertility, pellagra, skin rashes, mental deterioration, etc. The writer has divided vitamins into different categories. First type is of the fat-soluble vitamins. They are A, D, and E. Vitamin A is present in cod liver oil, butter and green vegetables. Its absence in the diet of young animals results in poor growth. Its deficiency reduces the natural resistance against the invading organisms, produces a dry condition of the eye, and impairs the power of vision. The second fat soluble vitamin is vitamin D. It is also found in cod liver oil and other animal fats. Its absence from the food reduces the growth and calcification of bones. It is thus the main cause of rickets. Rickets may be caused either by a shortage of vitamin D or by lack of sunlight. It is due to the fact that the body can obtain its vitamin D both by the mouth and the skin. When ultraviolet light from the sun strikes the skin, it converts a certain fat found there into vitamin D. Ultraviolet light can also increase the efficiency of the food that is used in the treatment of rickets. Vegetable oils can also be made useful by radiation with ultraviolet light. Rats suffering from rickets can be cured by rubbing irradiated oil on their skins. The third fat-soluble vitamin is vitamin E. It is also known as anti-sterility vitamin. The deficiency of this vitamin in men makes them sterile. This vitamin E is found in the majority of common foodstuffs, leaves and seedlings. In certain cases of human infertility, wheat germ oil, which is rich in vitamins, is given to the childless couples. The chief water-soluble vitamins are B and C. Absence of vitamin B causes beriberi. Beriberi is caused by eating polished rice whose pericarp or nutritive layer is removed by the modern method of milling. The main source of vitamin B is yeast. It contains six different substances. of different importance. One of these substances prevents beriberi and another pellagra. It is a tropical disease. It causes rashes on skin, changes in the mucous membranes, and mental deterioration. The second water soluble vitamin is vitamin C. It is antiscorbutic. It is present in fresh vegetables, peas and beans, and in some fruits. The writer says in a humorous and ironical manner that unfortunately the scientist who knows what food is necessary for health is considered only a theorist and not the practical man. So his advice is seldom sought. The result is that we still continue to remove that part of wheat that is rich in vitamins. Then to make good its deficiency, we use vitamins supplied by the chemist. We also bleach our flour by means of alkalis that destroys the vitamins. After this destroying all the vitamins needed for our health, we run to the chemist and purchase the same vitamins in the tablet form from him. Okay, now we will discuss the utility of vitamins on human body. Proteins, fats, carbohydrates, salts and water are some important ingredients of our food. They help man's body work properly and repair its wear and tear. But health cannot be maintained simply on a diet based on these substances. There are certain essential ingredients in the food whose absence causes various diseases. These essential ingredients are chemical bodies called vitamins. Vitamins like the enzymes and the internal secretions of different glands have a great effect on the body. Vitamins work together with enzymes. They release energy from digested food. They regulate the billions of chemical activities that occur in the body every minute of every day. Vitamin A helps keep teeth, tissue membranes, and skin healthy. It is extremely important for eyesight. Lack of vitamin A in our food may cause rough skin, digestive problems, improper tooth formation, and eye disease. Vitamin B helps the body by building protein, making antibodies, and making the red blood cells. A vitamin B deficiency may cause fatigue, dizziness, nausea, very sensitive skin, and muscle and nerve paralysis. Vitamin C is also connected with the health of bones, teeth, hormones, and blood vessels. It may help cataract, cancer, and heart disease. Its deficiency may cause inflamed gums, slow wound healing, stomach disorders, and skin problems. Vitamin D helps build strong and healthy bones and teeth. Vitamin E is involved with immune system. It may have a positive effect against cardiovascular disease and cancer. This is the main summary of this essay. So for examination point of view, you have to prepare as long as well as short questions. Thanks.